Hello everyone, this is Client Centric, Anna Ng, episode 55. Okay, now I'm in my house. So tonight, no makeup. Okay, so yeah, just want to share about handover. Because these few days, we did handover. So usually I'm representing the landlord. So just to share with the tenants who might be listening to this right now, or even the landlords. What kind of things when we do a handover means we take back the unit from the tenant, right? At the termination of the lease or the end of the lease, right? What are the things we need to take note of? Okay, because I find myself sometimes we repeat a lot of times, and then maybe I do a video. Next time I just share this with the tenant or with the landlord so they know roughly what to expect. Okay, most of the agents, their job will be done under the CEA guidelines. Under the CEA guidelines, right? The Council for Estate Agents, right? The job will be done once the tenant, the agent has done a handover for the tenants to move into the unit, meaning we pass the unit from the landlord to the tenant. Okay, but now I'm talking about the handover of taking back the unit for the landlord. This is something which most landlords find that is a problem, because a lot of times after 1.5 years or 2 years, or maybe when the tenancy has actually ended, then they cannot find the agent anymore. The agent disappeared, MIA. So they have to do back the handover themselves. Okay, some of my landlords, they pay me extra to do this for them because their previous agent has already gone. Okay, it's not there anymore to support them in this matter. Okay, so some of the key points for the tenants to understand is that usually the ones that we are doing is condos. Okay, condos, and now for the new HDBs, they have dressed up the house pretty nicely. So usually you will have aircons in the house. So the first thing for tenants to take note of is since the day you took on the lease, if there's aircons in the house, you know that under the contract, it's either you have to service the aircon every 3 months, okay, once for all the aircons in the house, or maybe sometimes it's 6 months, depends on what was written in the contract between you and the landlord. So it's advisable that once you move into the unit, okay, you take the keys, right, then it's best that you sign a contract with an aircon man, okay, for the services to come every 3 months for servicing, or you keep the receipt. Hello, Leonard. Hello. So you keep the receipt of such servicing so that you can prove to your owner every quarterly, that kind of thing. Okay. Then if the aircon spoil, then they cannot really blame you because you have been taking good care of the aircon for them. Okay. So then that's the aircon servicing. So upon the handover, the aircon receipts must be there. Lah. If you cannot show any receipt or any service sheets, CHITS, then the landlord may come against you and say that, oh, I think you never service at all, so you have to pay me. No, I deduct from your security deposit. And this is something that, oh, thanks, Leonard. So this is something that the tenants don't want to have, lah, right? Not, you don't want your security deposit to be forfeited or deducted for whatsoever reason. Okay, so the second thing is about the dry cleaning of the curtains. Okay, most of the condos that we're doing, right, the curtains are tailor-made. So they are of good quality. Before handing the unit to you, most of our landlords would have already dry cleaned the curtains, wash already, hang back on the rods for you, okay, or on the railings for you. So the thing is, when you as a tenant, when you're supposed to move out, right, okay, before your handover day back to the landlord, okay, please do dry clean the curtains. Check with the landlord, do they want it dry cleaned or just put into normal washing machine to wash will do. Okay, I believe most of them is dry clean. If the landlord has been able to provide you a receipt to show that they have dry clean before they pass it to you, then it's best that you dry clean and hang it back for them nicely. Lah. Do back the same. Okay. So when people are nice to you, do back nicely for others. Okay. Okay, so hang on. So then the third thing is about, okay, sorry. The third thing is not about security deposit. That one we leave until the last. The third thing is actually more of, yeah, see if I can change it right here. Okay, I can't. Okay, never mind. Okay, so the third thing is actually more of the cleanup of the unit. If the landlord has already done a professional cleaning for you before you move in, and has provided a receipt to show you that such works has already been done. So just note that when you are about to move out, right, before you hand over the unit back to them, also look back for the same or similar professional cleaners to do back for the landlord. Okay, do back the same as what they have done for you, so that you give them back a good unit. They can easily rent out to the next tenant without much hassle or delay. Then your security deposit will not be withheld for no good reason, right? Okay, so that's about the cleanup. If they have only obtained a normal part-time maid to clean for you, then of course they can't expect you to do a professional cleaning unless you really have given them a very shitty house. End of it. Okay, if you're not sure, you can always ask your agent to come and check on your unit before the actual handover, maybe a month ahead, just to check with your agent, hey, actually, what do you think I should do to the house so that we can facilitate a smoother handover later on to the landlord. Okay, so also based on reasonable landlords, they see that your unit is handed back in good condition, then they will be happy to hand you back the deposit. If they're very happy, sometimes they give you back on the same day and don't have to wait for 14 days or don't know how many days to return back to you or face the disputes later on. Okay, so then the other thing is about whose liability. Okay, so the liability of items, like sometimes when we hand over, it's very common that the light bulbs suddenly has no light already. Okay, so you as a tenant, if you know that some lights have been flickering, it's good that you change the light bulb yourself. Because you may say, oh, light bulb is only $5 or $4. Landlord can change it anytime. But if nowadays, people are so busy, you want them to change for you, can. They will also charge you for the hours of a handyman to come down. So a light bulb change may be, a light bulb to you may be just $5. But inclusive of the changing of light bulb, and if it requires a ladder to climb up to the ceiling to change that light bulb, it could easily cost you $55 or $60 just to change that light bulb. So you see, all these costs could be minimized and not be deducted off from your security deposit if you had done a good handover. Okay? So if you're not sure for tenants, please check with your own agent what are the things that is needed for you to comply with, so that you don't fall into the gray area and then at the mercy of the landlord later on, because on the handover day, you are ill-prepared, and then the landlord will be using all this to deduct money from your security deposit. Okay? So the last thing, of course, is the security deposit. A lot of tenants thought that since you already hold my 2 months of security deposit, right, and then my last month of rental, I don't have to pay. Actually, it's not true. Okay, recently, we have one case like that, and the tenant actually didn't pay for the last 1 month. Okay, but in this case, right, because she didn't pay, so the landlord is going to charge her like being late. So there's actually interest chargeable on the late rental payment. And this could also affect your security deposit to be refunded back to you. They will reduce further. Okay, so all these come into play. Then, okay, so for tenants, maybe what you could have done is, remember, at the point of moving in, okay, at the point of moving in, when you happily take the key from the landlord, right, within the first 30 days, there's a warranty defect. Usually in Singapore, okay, warranty defect. So for that part, right, I want you to take down photos and email to the landlord if possible, or to your agent, to tell them to inform your landlord of the defects you discovered in the house, and not wait until 2 years later. Then you say, oh, that time it was already there. So it won't be fair to you. The light won't be fair to you. So if you want to play safe, take pictures, note down, email to landlord, make sure they are aware of it, and if they can rectify it, they rectify it for you. Okay, the first 30 days. Because anything after 30 days, then they will check again whether is it your liability or landlord's liability, and how should the cost be split. Okay, so yeah, so today my sharing on this handover is more or less there. Okay, so usually for me, I will still do the handover of taking back the unit from the tenant back to the landlord. So after we have obtained the quotations from the landlord's side, he and his workmen, right, he will give us a quotation. Okay, we'll just, for my part, I will help my landlord to draft the email. Then after that, it's really between my landlord and the tenant to dispute on whatever charges they want to discuss upon already. Okay, because on the tenant side, maybe if the landlord tell you, oh, this one is going to be $800, but if you have a better contractor at a more reasonable price, you might perhaps propose this to your landlord and then see if you can minimize all the cost that is going to be deducted off from your security deposit. Okay, so I hope in future for all the handovers, it will be smoother with this video going forward. Yeah, okay. So if you have a unit to rent or to buy or to sell, you can look for me. My link is provided in this description of my video. Okay, so then that's all for my client-centric property episode 55. Okay, that's all. Thank you. Take care and bye-bye.